Hi, and thanks for checking out Hasura. One of the most common questions we get about Hasura has to do with resolvers. Resolvers is the way that the GraphQL schema will generally process your incoming data request through a query, execute that data request, and then return data back to the user. But at Hasura, we do things a little bit differently. We use a GraphQL engine. The Hasura engine will track different data sources under the hood, and then it will act as sort of a grand central for where those data requests should be handled. When I bring in a database, such as this Chinook example here, I can track the tables that I have. Now, the engine will know when I'm requesting data from this GraphQL, from this database, it will create SQL statements at runtime and execute those against my database. This allows me to have very performant requests, as well as reducing a lot of developer overhead. I can track other data sources as well, such as functions, which will be able to use my database's native functionalities. And if I have custom business logic, I can write a microservice and also add that to my schema so that when I request data from my microservice, I'm able to associate whichever Lambda or other provider I want to use to execute that data request. Now, if I have an actual GraphQL schema with existing resolvers, I can federate this in as well, and then Hasura will pass on the data request to that other API. Bringing it all together, I'm able to leverage this engine's awareness of my data landscape in a single unified entry point that has access to permissions, caching, and other functionalities that allow you to create faster applications faster. I hope that helped you understand a little bit about Hasura's approach, and we'll see you in the next video.